Welcome back to Great Day Live. And the second part of the dish, the one with the latest in pop culture. Fans of the TV show Friends will understand that reference. The one with? Okay, maybe not. We're going to talk about the upcoming Friends reunion special, which is slated to premiere in May on HBO Max. But first, Chef Wes and I are joined by Jeff Howard of Baptist Health Milestone Wellness Center, GDL's Joanne Dixon, WHAS 11's Corey Bryan, and singer Sylvia Walters. So let's dish and also dig in, right, Chef?
That's right. That's right. We're ready to eat.
Okay, go ahead. You can pass it out. So let's start with this. All of the Friends announced this weekend that, yes, the reunion is on. Everybody posted except for Joey, Matt LeBlanc. He posted a picture of Matt, and they said, it's happening.
I cannot wait. Cannot wait. I love them. They were just in my house all the time, I felt, in college, and I just am excited. And I'm glad that they all agreed to do it, because I think the bond is real, and we know they've had struggles throughout the years personally. Mm-hmm. But I just think it's going to be exciting to see them all together.
Sylvia, your thoughts?
Well, yeah, I used to like the show. When it was on, I really did enjoy it. The quirkiness of it. It was always a good time. It was always, you know, I like it. It'll be fun to see how everybody's changed.
Corey, Joanne, Friends fans.
Yes, and I'm super excited. But I love Jennifer Aniston so much, and so like I'm just excited to see her most of all.
Chef, what about you? Were you a fan of Friends?
Oh yeah, for sure, yeah.
I was a little surprised because usually it's like the biggest star is the one who doesn't come back, yeah. And yay for Jennifer Aniston.
And they all hang out all the time too, and like I love it when like people like cast are like super good friends.
But the only thing is, it's going to be on HBO Max, which right now, what in the world is that other than it's going to cost you $15? It comes out in May, but it will have some offerings. I mean, anybody else cut the cord?
Well, I'm a firm believer in this. I will do a trial for a week and get in and get out for any show that opens up. Everybody offers you a week for free. I watched The Breakfast Show like that. I have watched everything that I want to see like that, and I get in and get out. Sorry.
Love it.
HBO Max.
So we'll see. We'll see if people, they're trying to, as I saw online, out Netflix. Netflix. Okay, let's move on to topic number two. Speaking of reunions, First Wives Club stars Goldie Hawn, Bette Midler, and Diane Keaton are reuniting for a holiday comedy. If you recall, First Wives Club, that was a huge hit. Thoughts about them?
I love them. Diane Keaton's one of my favorite people on the planet. I feel like I know her. I do not, but I like love. I love all of them. I love all of them. I'm excited for it. They're amazing
together. I didn't realize the First Wives Club had such a cult following. I didn't realize it was such a big thing. So I watched it, and I'm amazed at doing a reunion, but I'm glad they are. I think it's lovely to have people of that generation getting work, and I love that there's a kinship for the group of women, that people want to see them again.
I love that they are just like, we are beautiful, strong women, we're just going to keep going. But this begs the question, so they are playing ladies who are trapped with their families and their new holiday comedy. Anyone ever been felt trapped with your families in the holidays?
Definitely.
I have felt trapped with other people's families during the holidays.
Wes, have you ever felt trapped? I know you've got great family.
Yeah. Of course, I do.
I like that. Okay, we're skirting on by.
I'm beating the fifth.
Topic number three, I love this. Lil Nas X, he crashed a wedding in Disney World. So he just waltzes right into the reception.
That's amazing.
Love it. Of course, they're playing Old Town Road. I think we beeped what that lady actually said on social media because that would get us in trouble with the FCC. So going around, who is the one celebrity that you would want to crash? I don't know, coffee, your birthday, Great Day Live, Sylvia.
Oh, wow. That list is just a little too long. I did see Diana Ross last night. Her crashing something that I did.
Oh, how was she?
She was amazing. She looked beautiful.
Did she show up on time?
She was radiant. Yeah.
Show up on time?
And
finish
her daughter,
on time?
Yeah, her daughter actually opened up the show with her own performance. And she did a really good job. And when Diana came out, it was like the world was here.
I love it. Okay, Jeff, really quickly.
Mine would probably be Ariana Grande, just because I'm kind of digging her right now, and I love the pony.
Okay. Chef, who do you want to crash?
I don't know. I'm a country music guy, so I'd probably be some country music singer. I don't know.
Pick any of the above.
I have a bunch that I would love, but I would say, but I'm going to go with Bill Murray just because that could happen. I've watched a documentary about him and all the like random people he meets. So.
Okay, Corey, what about you? One celebrity.
my former celebrity was Prince, but he's not here anymore. So that would have been mine.
That would have been yours. Yeah.
Angie, what about you?
I mean, we really have to ask.
Yeah.
Kenny Rogers. Stop Come by on. Anytime.
I did not know this for some reason. Really?
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
She's like the super fan.
I have an emotional reaction. Our executive producer just said, didn't you cry? Yes, Connor. I cried every single time that I've met Kenny Rogers. And he looked at me the last time and he goes, what did I do? You just were everything.
Like you exist.
Okay, last, really quickly, we have one quick photo. Just want to show you this. J-Lo posted this.
Fantastic.
And what has happened, though, is it's inspired other women and even some men to post photos of themselves saying, 50 and above, this is me, I'm a mom, I'm a dad, rocking it.
Right.
And a lack of really crappy social media comments.
Which is just ridiculous. I mean, she's like, obviously works really hard. I mean, yeah, she looks amazing. It's incredible. It's inspiring to me.
You know, it doesn't even matter. Her work ethic is so high. Even if her body didn't look like that and she were to post it with her background of her work ethics, I will always respect somebody that gets up and does the work, no matter what the outcome looks like.
Yeah, and she looks amazing.
I am betting she would enjoy some of Chef Wes's delicious pancakes.
Yeah.
By the way, just really quickly, the Trifecta Derby Gala will announce at 11 o'clock today. Their 2020 headliner. Last year, it was Usher. You can go to Trifecta Gala.
Maybe it's going to be Kenny Rogers.
It's not. You can go to TrifectaGala.com. And you can connect with Chef Wes on Facebook at Louisville Chef Wes by calling 502-438-9164. And then on his website, ChefWes.com. And, of course, you can see him every Monday right here on Great Day Live. We're going to post these delicious flapjack recipes on our website as well. We're coming right back with more Great Day Live.